Residents of Bexar County and the rest of Texas are hit continually with what would have been seen as systematic, unjustified, and unduly burdensome increases in property taxes. But we all know property taxes help fund our schools. Considering that some people propose that childless people not pay school taxes, while residents over age 65 should not need to pay property taxes on their homes, what steps do you propose to better protect taxpayers and ease property tax burdens?
So I've been an advocate for many years now that the right approach, the fairest approach, the economically efficient approach for funding the necessary role of government is actually a consumption tax. I want to move to get rid of the property tax. That won't happen overnight, but we have to be serious about changing the way we're thinking, because the property tax is an inefficient way to collect revenue. It's an unfair way to collect revenue, and it really doesn't give back to the overall economy in a way like a consumption tax would. So what we need to do in the meantime is look at valuation reform. Most people, if you go back and ask yourself or think yourself 10 years ago where you looked at it and you thought your property tax valuation was below market rate, right? Most of us sort of have that perception that it is, so we complain, but really we're complaining about the fact that the market's booming. Well, somewhere along the line, that shifted. I sold my house, we moved next door, not too far. But we sold our house last week. We sold it for 20% below what Bexar County Appraisal District had listed for. And so I said, you know what, let's do a little research. We went back and looked at 30 recent sales in District 121, southern, central, and northern part of the district. 60% of those homes were overvalued by the appraisal district based upon their most recent sale in the last 90 days. This is the kind of thing that gets people ticked off. We are a proud people, we are a generous people, but we hate being ripped off and treated unfairly. 60% of home sales are getting ripped off. That's money they don't get back at closing. I paid too much property tax over the last several years, and I protested every year, by the way. All of the people in Bexar County are hurting under a regime that is fundamentally unfair in how it's set up, and it's grossly ridiculous. I can't say it enough. We need to get rid of the property tax eventually, but from now until the time in which we can do that, we need to have reform and reduction, and so I want to make sure we support the governor's plan on that.
A consumption tax? We are consumed to death right now, my gosh. You know what it would take to do a consumption tax? You know what would property taxes take out of our budget right now? We'd have a sales tax of about 40-50%. You know what you could buy with that? Not much. Couldn't buy milk, couldn't buy diapers, couldn't buy a car, because there wouldn't be any car dealerships. You'd have to go to Oklahoma, New Mexico, Louisiana to buy a car. A consumption tax? Whoa. That's just insane, and I hope we don't go there. My gosh, I'm startled. Because that is so off-base and so out of thinking and so out of line. We can't tolerate something like that. We have to address property tax. And here's how we do it. You look at your property tax bill, what's the biggest piece? School taxes. 50-60% of your bill is school taxes. If we get the state to live up to its constitutional requirement of properly funding education, shift that burden from the taxpayers, us, back to the state where it's supposed to be, no new tax, no consumption tax or anything else, my gosh, immediately our property taxes come down. Immediately. Step two, the governor's come up with a good plan to try to stop the bleeding a little, or slow it down, where he caps property tax revenue increases at 2.5%. It's still 2.5%, or up to 2.5%, which could be a significant number, particularly as market values rise, and they need to, and they should, that helps all of us. So a third step needs to be, as market values continue to rise, that's fine, that helps us, but for tax purposes, we cap it at 80%. So that way we have the immediate relief that we all want, short-term protection under the governor's plan that I fully support, and then the long-term protection with the cap. That's how we do it, but not consume us even more.
Karen, we said if we had pointed accusations that we'd have a chance to respond. So let me real quick just, if I can't respond. You made an assertion there that would have to be a 40% increase in the property tax or in the sales tax. So first and foremost, a consumption tax is the way that the state raises most of its revenue in the first place. So if you want to cut the property tax, you've got to have that revenue be replaced somehow. And it would be through a consumption tax. But I'm an IT guy. I provide professional services. If I sell you $1,000 of IT services, I'm going to put sales tax on it because the state tells me to. If Steve, as a lawyer, puts $1,000 in professional services and invoices you for that, he doesn't put sales tax on it. Now, what's the difference? I think the lawyers have better lobbyists in Austin than IT nerds do, but in reality, the fact is we have to build the base bigger. This nonsense about it being 40%, even in the worst case projections, it moved the sales tax up 1.5%. So let's not be lying about stuff that you don't know what you're talking about. Let's be serious about having a conversation about how we improve Texas over the long haul.